A common calculation for finance professionals or analysts is to get year-to-date values. Now, there are many different ways of doing this, and it really depends on your data set. But usually, these formulas can get quite complex. So we thought we're going to use one of the new Excel functions called the scan function to get this year-to-date calculation, and we're going to do it with a single formula. So we don't even have to drag the formula down. It's just going to spill down. We wanted to keep it as simple as possible, so let me show you what we came up with. And while I do that, I'm going to introduce you to the scan function. Just a heads up, this function is currently in beta in Office Insiders. So here I have some sales data per month. This is formatted as an official Excel table. We can see the table is called sales. Now, as a first step, let's do a to-date calculation using the scan function, and then we're going to see how we can tweak it to give us year-to-date results. So we're going to start off with scan. We need an initial value. This is the value for your accumulator. Now, it's going to make sense in a second. I'm going to go with a zero here. Next comes the array. So this is the range that we want to process, which is our sales column. Next is the function. So here, we're going to use the lambda function. With Lambda, you can create your own tool, or basically your own machine, that's going to take each single number here in this range and process it. You just have to make sure that you create the right tool to process it properly. Now, Lambda in scan requires two parameters. One is your accumulator. I'm just going to call it A, so that's just a placeholder. You can, of course, call it anything you want. You don't need to use quotation marks here. You just type in the name. Next is the placeholder for each number in this range. I'll just go with B here. You can, of course, call this also whatever you want. Now comes the calculation. For that, we're not going to be referencing cells anymore, but we're going to be using these placeholders. For to-date, I just need to add A to B. So A plus B, close off Lambda, close scan, press Enter, and everything spills automatically. My first result is the same here, then the sum of these two equals this one here. And it goes all the way to the bottom. So this 198,321 is the sum of this entire column, and we can see that number here as well. Now the scan function is confusing to understand, so I'm going to switch to slides and let's go through the steps. We start off with our month and sales column. We use the scan function and get our to-date values. That's how the function looks. Now let's take a look at what happens at each single stage. So in the first stage here, we have A equals to zero. The zero is coming from the initial value of our accumulator. B is the first value that we have in our range here, which is the range that we selected up here. The tool that we created just adds A and B together, which gives us 8603. Now in the next stage, the 8603 becomes A again. So the value of A plus B becomes A. B is the next value that we have in sales. A plus B equals 18,290. What happens in the third stage? What is A now? A is 18,290. B is the next value here. A plus B is 26,101. And this loop continues till the end. Now let's switch back to Excel and see how we can get this loop to reset every time we come across a new calendar year. Somehow, the scan function needs to also take a look at the month column. So as it's scanning sales, it has to see, has it come across January, for example, if you're using a standard calendar, or if you have a fiscal calendar, has it come across July? Notice that my month and year combination is input as an actual date. So what I have in the cells is not text. Instead, it's a date that represents the first day of each month. Now let's set up our year-to-date function. We're going to start off with scan. Initial value is the same as before. The array is our sales column. Now we need to create our little lambda function, so our tool that's going to process the values. We need an accumulator. I'll just go with A here. And we need a variable that represents each single number in this range. I'm just going to keep B for that. Now, instead of just doing A plus B, we need to do a check. And we need to check whether the month that's right beside B, so wherever B happens to be, if that month happens to be January or not. We can do that check using the if function. We need to take a look at the month number. I'll use the month function here. Now, somehow we need to get to the column that's right beside sales. For that, I'm going to use the offset function. My reference is B, so whichever cell I happen to be on. Then offset needs me to tell it how many rows to go down. I don't want it to go down any rows, so I'm going to skip that argument. Now, how many columns do I want to move? Well, I want to move to the column that's before sales. I'm going to go with -1 here. If your month column is on the other side, you're just going to put a 1. Now let's close off the offset function and close the month function. This is going to give us the month number of the cell that's right beside B. Now we're going to check whether this does not equal to 1. So if we haven't come across January, then we want A plus B. So we want to take our accumulated value and add the current cell's value to it. But if we happen to be in January, so if our month number equals 1, we need to reset the accumulator but keep B. So if we multiply 0 with A, that should reset the accumulator, and then we add B. Now let's close off the brackets and see what we get. We have 8603 here. These are the same as to date, but everything should reset when we come across January, and it does. And then the year-to-date calculation goes on and it resets again when it comes across the next year. The great thing about using tables as a reference is that our formulas are all dynamic. So if I just drag this down, and let's just put 100 here for these months as well, and we can see that our year-to-date gets calculated. The moment we come across January the next year, everything is reset, and then everything is accumulated again. What if you need to reset everything in July? Well, we just have to change this to a 7. Instead of changing this directly in the formula, you could, of course, use a cell reference and use the let function and define a variable for that. So we're just going to test that one out, and we should see everything reset in July. Now the sum of these equals 50,929. That's how we managed to tweak the scan function to give us a year-to-date calculation. Offset is a volatile function, so I'm not sure about the impact it has if I use it in the lambda function. So if you have other ways of solving this, please share it in the comments. So that's an example of the scan function. Honestly, I think these lambda helper functions aren't really for everyone, so if you're one of those people, thank you for watching. And if you've been playing around with these lambdas and you have other solutions, please share below. Thank you for watching, thank you for being here, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.